You're watching The Business Channel, creating business class programs. Victaulic is a global company based in the US which manufactures mechanical grooved piping systems. Well, here with me is the engineering specifications manager for the UK, Gareth Sherrington-Boyd. Hello to you.
Good morning.
Now, tell me a bit more about the company and the products.
Well, Victaulic was founded in 1925 in New York City, but the origin behind the concept was actually brought to fruition in the UK, actually in London, in 1918 by a chap called Ernest Tribe, who was a Royal Engineer for the British Army. The product itself was created for invasion piping, for water transfer lines, oil transfer lines, things like that. By the time the product was actually invented, though, the war was over, and it sort of sat in a patent office in London. But 1925, the company was formed in New York based on that concept. The company back in the UK was called the Victory Joint Company. So my company, Victaulic, created the name Victaulic through Victory through hydraulics. So then Victaulic was born.
And how does the piping system differ from the normal way of joining pipes?
Traditional methods would dictate welding, flanging. These are a longer concept on installation. If you can imagine welding a flange onto a piece of pipe at, say, 4 inch, you would be looking at around 30 minutes. With Victaulic, we can roll groove in 5. So it's a massive labour saving and time schedule saving for the client and the engineers.
So what kind of applications would your products lend themselves to? Would it be for piping water or gas around a building?
Well, we operate on all services throughout except for gas and high temperature hot water through to steam. Any services outside of those applications, we have a solution for the application. If you were to take this building, for example, there will be potable drinking water, there will be cooling water for the air conditioning, and there'll be low temperature hot water. We would be able to cover all those services. I know we're talking sort of commercial London today, but we do operate in many vertical markets, from power to marine, mining. So it's numerous. There really isn't many applications we can't be involved in.
Now, you mentioned some different sectors there, but does it tend to be new construction that you work on, or retrofit, or both?
No, our product leans very much towards both. With retrofit, you find normally the building contractor will be on site, kind of working as he goes, working through the design, because there's so many other services already there. I've worked personally on many buildings where there's still people working in there. So there's some nighttime work that needs to be done, or there's some noise levels. So there are some challenging applications for this from a time restraint, which means with our grooving tools, you can, in the field, on site, produce the groove in the pipe and construct and build as you go. For new construction, we lean towards that as well. From a fabrication off-site point of view, we can help with sort of coordinated drawings and planning. So really both sort of sectors work equally as well for us.
Now, innovation is very important to CIBSE members. I mean, do you mainly just have the one idea, or are you always innovating and coming up with new products?
Innovation is very important to us because it really is what sets us out as the market leader, as the world leader. We have numerous products that have been invented by us, manufactured by us, that have patents and cover, so it makes us very unique. Quicker ways to install, that's basically the crux of what we're trying to do. How can we cover as many bases as possible with as many conversations that we need to have in our job site cycle? So from the owner to the engineer to the building contractor, we have unique opportunities for each sector to talk about. We brought a new product into the market in the UK maybe 3 years ago, which it was a new push-on coupling technology. So rather than having to dismantle the coupling and the housings, lubricate the gasket on installation, the product is actually manufactured as a push-on coupling, needs no lubricant, and is obviously 15 times quicker to install than the traditional coupling, which is obviously still quicker than traditional methods. So we found the concept originally, and we've sort of tried to develop it, and now we found something new to even improve on something that we invented originally.
And looking at innovation, even into the future, what innovations are we seeing in the way that buildings and particularly piping systems are constructed?
With the construction market, it's more of a software technology innovation. We have a division within Victaulic called CPS, which is Construction Piping Services. They're a design team. So how it really works from my role, for example, is I will go and meet with an engineer at a consulting practice in London. We'll discuss the project, and really we can be involved as early as possible. The earlier the better, in fact. We'll discuss the project, and maybe we can take some drawings away. And what CPS do is they'll analyse the drawings, and they'll flip the drawing that they've got into a Victaulic solution. And when I say software, we're very much heavily involved in BIM, which is Building Information Modelling, which is very much, a part of the future of the construction landscape.
What do you see as driving innovation? Is it people trying to get the costs down or to become more sustainable?
I think it's all of the above, and that's what's great about Victaulic, is we're kind of involved in all those conversations at every level. We have people that work for Victaulic who are heavily involved in big building regulation committees and so on throughout the country. Obviously, a global manufacturer, each country's got its own building regulations, so we need unique guys to be able to work in these sectors. But I think innovation being forced forward is a certain cost issue. You know, people are trying to build the buildings at less cost. I think building schedule is massively important. The less time it takes you to build your building, the quicker you can put people in it, and people you can start getting rent back. So I think really all of the above, and I also believe that a square meterage price of office space in London, I think, is probably at its highest at the moment. And I think footprint and finding products that can do the job that you wanted it to do maybe 10 years ago, but for half the size.
What are the costs and payback for innovative engineering for buildings in terms of the grooved piping systems?
Well, it's sort of across the whole spectrum, really. If you look at the owner or engineer conversation, obviously the engineer is representing his client, and in specifying a Victaulic system, what he gets is a building that's much easier to maintain long term. It's very well talking about contractors building the building and scheduling and so on, but in 10 years' time, the owner of the building and the client still needs a building that works. He still needs a certain amount of maintainability. And I think with our products, it's a much easier system to maintain long term. But on the job site, the answer is simple. It's schedule. If one thing takes an hour and the next thing takes 10 minutes, you only have to pay that person for 10 minutes to do it, and you can also do a lot more in that time than you would have done in the hour. And again, talking about schedule, projects like Crossrail throughout London at the moment, there are certain times of the day that you're only allowed to work. Therefore, you can do more in your 3 hours a day than you would be able to with more traditional products. And I think with our on-field and off-site fabrication capabilities and our design and BIM, a much more pre-planned project is worth its weight in gold if managed properly.
Well, Gareth Sherrington-Boyd from Victaulic, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.